Good morning. Welcome to Weekly Singapore Stocks with Jonathan. Today is 12th of June 2012 and it is a little bit later than usual. Why? Because it's all IT shows fault. I bought some toys and I was figuring it out and somehow it caused the laptop not to work, so I'm unable to do the recording over the weekend. But here it is. Today, Singapore Strait Times went up close to 50 points and we had a fantastic rally today. Why? Mainly over the weekend, Spain got bailed out, especially with China rate cut. When it was very bearish, everyone thought China was really slowing down. China over the weekend came out a report that says, hey, we are picking up too. Hey, we are all past the stage. So you notice that whenever market needs a rebound, good news just comes in. Whenever market needs to sell down, bad news will just coincidentally will come in. Isn't it? Funny, isn't it? So it's somehow that you're able to predict the chart, that when will the good news be coming out, when will the bad news be coming out. Okay, and last week, Ben Bernanke came out of Congress, says that this is what he's going to do to the US economy. Nothing. Well, as expected, isn't it? Operation Tarp is still in play till end of this month. He's not going to announce something while Operation Tarp is still Operation Twist or Tarp or whatever. Operation something. It's still moving. So why announce something when the plan is still not over yet? Okay? So this week, something major happening today. Today is Bradley turn date, major turn date, 12th of June 2012. So we shall see. Plus, this week, starting off is UEFA Cup. Plus, coming soon is London Olympic. So a lot of things that happens in the month of June. And I have a homework for you. Go back and take a look at historical month of June every single month for the last how many years. Just go to Yahoo website. Just check Strait Times in the month of June. You will realize that not only Strait Times but also S&P or Dow Jones. You will realize that month of June, usually most of the time, it has a market turning date during the month of June. That's the easy part. Okay, the hard part. This year, January was supposed to be a turning month. It did not happen again. Very rare. In the last 10 years, very rare that in January, there was no market turning point. But this year, it did happen. So now, the easy part is we know there's a high probability that June will be the turning month. The hard part is figuring out when will it be. Okay? So, do take note of that. Next. STI today went up 50 points. Dow Jones in the morning was positive 170 over points. So we should expect Dow Jones right now as of 1:33 a.m. in the morning. It should be positive 180. It's minus 15. So right now, if you take a look, throughout the day, it gap up. This is S&P futures in 5-minute chart. It was gapping up and then in the afternoon the market in S&P futures turned weaker and right after Strait Time close it went even lower. First of all, why a lot of people on Friday cut loss then gap up? Dow Jones went up. Then when everyone long, market comes down. Isn't it funny that somehow the market knows your trade? Somehow when you long, the market goes opposite direction, and when you short, the market goes the opposite direction too, isn't it? So you realize that we as a human being are trained, that we know to enter the market exactly. We're able to buy at the day high, we're able to sell at the day low, exactly. We are well trained. So what I need you to do is write a letter to the broker house or write a letter to SGX. Ask them, please, the broker platform, modify their broker platform. Since a lot of people are very accurate buying at the day high, selling at the day low, all you need is just ask the broker to switch the buy and the sell button exactly opposite. So in other words, when you're thinking of buying, when you click buy, it's actually you're clicking sell. And when thinking about clicking sell, you're actually clicking on buy. Isn't it? Then we are 100% accurate that we are able to always buy at the day low and sell at the day high. That good. Alright, Now, enough of that. So let's take a look at S&P. S&P, which I use SPY, you realize that, oh, I shall use this instead, since market is moving right now. If you take a look today, we gap up, major gap up, and then sell down as of right now. Right now, as of 135, is 1322.25. That's S&P. You realize that, right? We had a major gap up. The gap up came very close to this head and shoulder, that support, prior support, close to now future resistance. Best friend become worst enemy. Okay? Plus, on the upside, there is a lot of rising trend line here that acts as your worst enemy. So in other words, there are resistance on the upside. Okay, so the first resistance to watch out for is 1352. The next resistance to watch out for will be about 1378 or 1380, there about the levels. So pay attention to the resistance at that level. Support, it must not break below this level, which is about 1268. Okay, that's S&P futures. Next, in terms of Euro US dollars on a daily chart. Oops, wrong one. Euro dollars on the daily chart. You realize that today we form a bearish engulfing candle. This bearish engulfing today consume 1-2 candles. So in terms of Euro US dollars today, ain't that bullish. Okay. Prior to that, there was actually a sign, because you realize that every time gap up, there is a window. Window sooner or later will close. And right now, we just close that window. Okay. Next, in terms of gold movement has been very erratic. We have a hammer here. We have a hammer lookalike here. We have another hammer lookalike here. And yes, sorry, on Friday, we also had a hammer lookalike. Okay. So right now you notice that there was a shooting star prior to the selling down. So do take note of that. So as of right now, there are no signals in gold. Next, in Shanghai. You will notice that Shanghai, watching my YouTube previously I drawn this chart before. The symmetrical triangle in Shanghai, it broke down from the symmetrical triangle. Now, if it's going to go higher, okay, if it's going to go higher, do watch out for that. This could be a possible resistance at this level. This level right here is about 2340, which will coincide with the 20-day moving average. And if I zoom in closer, you realize that there's a lot of moving average and the very top. Right now Shanghai is below the 20, below the 50, below the 100, and below the 200. Not that bullish after all. Okay, next, Hang Seng. In terms of Hang Seng, it gap up above the 20-day moving average. Prior to that was resisted by the 20-day moving average, but don't get too happy yet, because right now we are in a downtrend. Everything right here is lower high, lower low. The first resistance to watch out for in Hang Seng Cash would be the levels of 19,000 and 50 thereabouts. Okay, so do pay attention to Hang Seng at that resistance level. Next, the support, if it goes lower, do pay attention to that. There is a rising window acting as a support right there. The levels are about 17,200 to 17,500, that 300 points level right there. So do watch out for that support right there. Next, if it goes higher, you will notice that this particular line, the 50, is going to cross the 200 right there. So that will be a first resistance to watch out for. That level of resistance would also coincide with the FIBO 50%. Let's see, do we have any levels right there? No. Basically will coincide the FIBO 50%. That's about it. Okay, so do watch out. Oops. Do watch out for that particular levels. That particular levels at FIBO 50% is hate this. The particular Fibonacci 50% is at about 19,700. So do pay attention right there. Next, in terms of ABM KLCI, Malaysia Stock Exchange, you will notice that do be a little bit careful because it has a shooting star look-alike today. Although the good news is it closed above the 50-day moving average. Massive rally, fantastic rally when the entire world was coming down, KLCI is able to rebound higher. Maybe, do you remember right now is the school holidays? Supposed to have the election announced, but up to today there was no election news, so we shall see. Market could be expecting the election, but so far no news yet. Okay, so do watch out for resistance. To watch out for right now, we are at the high of the resistance at about 1580. Next level resistance would be at about 1590. Okay, so do pay attention to that. Strait Times today went up higher, kept up and closed 50 points above, mainly due to the Spain's bailout. It was so bullish, the Dow Jones was positive 170, but yet right now Dow Jones is minus 23. Oh boy. So in other words, right now it is as if Dow Jones is about minus 200 because we factored in positive 170 points. Okay, so do be careful. Straight times, levels to watch out for. If you pay attention to, very similar to Hang Seng, Straight Times also has a rising window acting as a support right there, which should be a very strong support from about 2630 to 2650, that levels. Of course, the first level of support you need to pay attention to is this recent low, which is about 2700. Okay, next, if it goes above, the resistance to pay attention to is 2810 and of course 200 day moving average currently at about 2830. Okay, now banks today gap up, but unfortunately it didn't run as much as what it's supposed to be. It gap up and hit a moving average resistance for DBS, the 20 day moving average. OCBC just close above the 200 day moving average, but there is a 20 day moving average acting as a resistance just overhead there. UOB, we are also coming close to the 50 day moving average. Okay, I'll come to a summary in a short while. Okay, but for you, take a look and you'll notice that SGX, even if it go higher, there is resistance on the upside. Excuse me. Okay, resistance on the upside right here where the 50 are going to cross the 200. Next, in terms of commodity, today commodity ran, especially Olam. Olam broke above the recent high of about 1.685, gap up, flew higher. So it closed above the 20-day moving average, fantastic run for Olam. We also, Sakari, gap up, but it didn't move. Noble Group, gap up, but it may be trying to do like Sakari. Of course, the resistance to watch out for would be today's high of 1.145. So do watch out. However, overhead resistance, we have a resistance at about 1.19. So do be very careful. Okay, do like it or not, you are trading counter trend. Okay, if I remember previously, yes, there was a bullish divergence right there in MACD histogram and stochastic, and a small one in RSI. But do take note, this histogram as of this moment is already being played out, because usually divergence means there's potential change of trend. Right now this is a downtrend changing to a sideway, so it's already being played out. Okay, so don't count too much on changing of another trend to the upside yet. Right now we have not seen yet. Okay, we have not seen that yet. Next, Marines. Where's Marines? Highlighted in the Chartered Academy Inner Circle Group says to pay attention to Sembcorp. Sembcorp today already highlighted, it says if it goes higher than the highest high of Friday, high is a signal to enter long. So indeed today, gap up, little bit of profit taking, went above and stay above the 50-day moving average and rallied. So highlighted Sembcorp, that's the trade Sembcorp being made. Another counter is being highlighted or share with you, that's in properties, but no trade on that. Marines, Keppel Corp, also now hit the 20-day moving average. You'll notice that I've been saying a lot of counters are coming close to resistance, so do be a little bit careful. In terms of Sembmarine, also like Sembcorp, get above the high, went higher. Okay, it closed above the 20-day moving average. Costco, we are now near the resistance. Yangzijiang, also near that resistance. But Yangzijiang also hit the 200-day moving average. Next, in terms of properties, CapitaLand, this was also highlighted in the Chartered Economic Inner Circle group. However, there was no trade being done here because it gap up. There was a bull flag being seen in CapitaLand, short-term bull flag, but there was no trade done because the risk and reward is just not worth it because of this gap up. Alright, so you notice now we are very close to the 50-day moving average. Next, Hobie. On Friday, had a nice hammer. Today went up. Unfortunately, there was a selling pressure being encountered after hitting the 20-day moving average. So it came back down. Okay, so there was a hammer on Friday. And CapitaLand. Okay, CapitaLand was also highlighted. No, sorry, CapitaLand wasn't. CapitaLand was highlighted right about here as a shorting potential. And there was a hammer right here for a rising higher, for move up. But do take note, moving average acting as a resistance is just on overhead. Okay, so in summary, this is option expiration week. Oh, by the way, also an option expiration week. Also Bradley turn date. If we go higher, do be careful right now because a lot of counters are downtrend. We are coming close to a moving average acting as a resistance. Plus, right now with Dow Jones minus 32 points, we basically factored in 170 points futures. It's gone. Okay? So, it's gone. So, in other words, tomorrow, everyone will be panicking. So, if you have long position, do watch your stop loss. Be very careful. If you have short position, well, also watch your stop loss because potentially we may go higher. But just be a little bit careful because right now, technically, there are some counters that having a short signal. But right now, the mid is not as much. I will hope that at least it goes up to the moving average as a resistance so there are more mids to be built up. Okay, so do take note and do be a little bit careful. Market is extremely volatile. Market is really moving really fast. So if you cannot watch the market really closely, best you just stay away and just watch how the market are being played out. Just enjoy the movie. Okay, so if you'd like to find out more, just go to my website chartingacademy.com. Over here, this is where I try to see any signals. I share as much as I can right here. If you're not joined my mailing circle, do join. It is free. If you don't like it, you can opt out at any point of time. And if you'd like to find out how to join in the Chartered Academy Inner Circle Facebook group, that's where you find out what's the criteria to join my Inner Circle. So I wish you all the very best and do be very safe. Thank you.